Samantha Spinner.
Library presents Samantha Spinner and the Super Secret Plans by Russell Ginns. Read for you by Kathleen McInerney with Grover Gardner. And including bonus audio puzzles created and presented by the author at the end of this audiobook.
The Eiffel Tower. The Eiffel Tower stands in the heart of Paris, France. Built for a World's Fair, it was completed in 1889. At 1,063 feet high, it's the tallest building in the city. For more than 40 years, it was the tallest building in the world. Every year, millions of visitors ride the elevator to the top and gaze upon the beautiful city of Paris. The tower is made out of huge iron beams connected by metal fasteners called rivets. There are more than 2.5 million rivets holding the massive structure together.
One of the rivets isn't a rivet at all, but a button. Look for it 2 feet up on a large support beam at the northeast corner of the first platform. It stands out from the other rivets because it is shiny silver and not painted brown. Press it, and you'll hear a soft, low hum. After 60 seconds, a hatch will open, revealing a ladder stretching the length of the support beam. Enter and descend. The pull of air will become stronger as you climb down. You may let go at any time. Before you hit the ground, you'll be sucked into a pneumatic tube. Chapter 1. Unexplained Vanishing Person. Samantha went searching for Uncle Paul. Nobody had seen him for days. On Friday morning, he'd made strawberry waffles and helped everyone get ready for the day. He reminded Buffy to include her books and pencils in the large handbag she lugged to school. Then he waited for the bus with Samantha and Nipper, and he walked their pug Dennis to the park and back. After he dropped Dennis at home, he shuffled across the driveway in his bright orange flip-flops to his one-room apartment above the garage. That was the last anyone had heard or seen of him. When she looked for him on Saturday, Samantha figured he was at the flea market, where he traded snow globes and souvenirs every weekend. But she couldn't find him then, or on Sunday either. So, on Sunday evening, she went up the stairs and peeked through his apartment door. His crates of books, magnets, stickers, and maps were stacked neatly against the wall, but there was no sign of him anywhere. On Monday morning, he didn't show up to make breakfast. That was when the whole Spinner family agreed that Uncle Paul was officially missing. Two police officers came to investigate, and Samantha's dad lent them an extra powerful flashlight. They seemed a lot more interested in the experimental high candle power light bulb than anything they shined it on in Uncle Paul's apartment. They returned to the spinner's kitchen after a 5-minute search.
"We didn't see anything out of the ordinary," one officer told them. "We can't say for certain that he's dead."
"Dead?" all 5 spinners asked at the same time.
"Well, there's always a chance that he's alive somewhere,"
said the other officer. As he spoke, he picked up 2 apples from the kitchen counter and juggled them absent-mindedly with one hand.
"Sometimes uncles just go missing without telling anyone," he said,
and put the apples back on the counter. They promised to fill out an unexplained vanishing person form and left. Soon after that, Mrs. Spinner headed off to the North Seattle Animal Hospital, where she was director of rodent and lizard care. Mr. Spinner left for the American Institute of Lamps, where he was senior light bulb tester. And Buffy, forgetting her books and pencils, grabbed her giant handbag and walked to school. For the first time in years, Samantha and her brother Nipper waited by themselves for the bus. Of course, Samantha knew that Uncle Paul would never just go missing without telling anyone, especially her. She knew something was deeply wrong, but she had no idea what to do about a missing uncle. So when the bus pulled up, she climbed on board and went to school. That afternoon, all 3 kids gathered under the basketball net hanging outside their uncle's apartment.
"Last week, I showed Uncle Paul this new hat and this new handbag," said Buffy.
She held them up as evidence for Samantha and Nipper to examine.
"Usually, he'd make a joke about how I need a 550-room mansion for all my accessories," she recalled with a sigh. "But he didn't tease me at all. Maybe he knew he was doomed."
"Maybe he was kidnapped," said Nipper. "Maybe he exploded."
Buffy thought about that and looked around.
"If he did, then where are all the blown-up pieces of hideous orange shoes?" she asked.
Samantha was pretty sure Uncle Paul hadn't exploded. Her brother and sister were exactly as helpful as she expected them to be. Not much at all. She left them standing under the basketball net and headed down the block to Volunteer Park. In the center of the park, an art museum overlooked the city, with a view of downtown Seattle and the Olympic Mountains far in the distance. Uncle Paul spent a lot of time at that museum, so Samantha hoped she might get some help from Olivia Turtle, head of museum security. When Samantha told her about Uncle Paul's disappearance, Olivia seemed worried too. Unfortunately, not for the same reasons as Samantha.
"So he just went missing?" Olivia asked slowly.
Samantha nodded.
"Well, I hope you find him, young lady," she said. "There's a big convention here next month, and security guards are coming from all over the world. I was going to ask your uncle to be on my trivia quiz team."
She adjusted her badge.
"Nobody knows about art and architecture like Pajama Paul," she said.
It always bothered Samantha when people called her uncle Pajama Paul. True, he did walk around in green plaid pajamas and a pair of bright orange flip-flops all day, every day. She had never seen him wearing anything else. But there was so much more to Paul Spinner than plaid pajamas. Every night, he would sit with Samantha and Nipper on the stairs to his apartment above the garage and tell stories about amazing places all over the world. He talked about the Great Wall of China and a mountain city called Machu Picchu. He talked about what it would have been like to travel on the Titanic. He knew an awful lot about cathedrals and fountains and faraway countries, especially for someone who wore green plaid pajamas and bright orange flip-flops all day, every day. He taught Samantha how to say please
where is the tallest building in the city, and thank you in 11 languages. Every now and then, he'd come back from the flea market with something interesting and give it to Nipper. Last year, he'd given Nipper an old postage stamp with a picture of an upside-down airplane on it. Nipper took it to school on a windy day, and it blew away during recess. Buffy made it clear that she didn't want anything from the flea market. Nothing involving fleas of any kind was welcome in her life. Paul didn't bring items for Samantha either. Instead, he'd always bring her a story, or a riddle, or an amazing fact about the world. Sometimes, she'd even help him find things to collect and trade. Samantha spent the next several days looking for secret magnets or stickers left behind by her uncle to let her know he was all right or that he was thinking about her. She looked everywhere in the house and around the neighborhood. She found nothing. After a week, Samantha's parents finally let her investigate the apartment above the garage. She led Nipper and Dennis up the stairs, and the three of them sniffed around. The sofa bed was closed up neatly. Dozens of books about everything from ancient weapons to scuba diving filled one tall bookcase. There were also a lot of books about travel and languages. The two wooden crates Uncle Paul carried to the flea market each Saturday were full of his usual collections.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.